I haven't spoken to you, haven't seen you in months. Too busy living, so we feel out of touch.
Yeah, I think, you know, we put out Mama's Boy October of 2020, and mm-hmm. we were faced with a decision. We could either sit on the couch and hope that the world opens back up, or we could go and make another album and also sit on the couch and hope the world opens back up. So we chose to do that. And I think, you know, kind of putting out two albums in less than a year is no easy task. So if we were going to push ourselves that hard, I just wanted to make sure that we were going to have fun mm-hmm. and that we were going to make the songs that we wanted to make and work with the people we wanted to work with and just really enjoy ourselves. So that's exactly what we did. And I guess I started writing for the album December 18th, 2020. Wow. So I took like a month or so off after putting out Mama's Boy and then went right back into the studio. And it just started to really like take shape. And we worked with Andrew Goldstein, who has helped us produce the album top to bottom, and just had the best time, had a blast. And I think you can really hear that in the songs.
Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had?
No, I didn't. You know, like with Malibu Nights, that was just so unapologetically a breakup album. And to a certain extent, it was a concept album. And the concept was getting your heart absolutely run over. With this album, I didn't want to make a concept album. I didn't want to write 12 songs about the same thing. I wanted to skip around, you know, like there's songs on this album that are like, I love you so much. And then two songs later, it's like, I don't want to be with you anymore. Let's break up. and I just, I don't know how many more songs we need about the same thing. And I thought it was really, really fun to just, you know, if you were to look at the album, it's not like the last three pages of my journal. It would be like the last 3 years or 5 years, you know, and the ebbs and flows of human emotion over the course of 5 years is drastic and crazy and huge. And I liked making that kind of album.
Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had?
You know, with Mama's Boy, it was a complete departure from what people are used to hearing from us. And that was on purpose. The way I talk about Mama's Boy is, you know, like when you're dating somebody and things are going well, you've been together for like a year or so, and you're like, hey, I want to take this to the next level. I think you should go home and meet my family and meet my friends and see where I grew up. And there's going to be some things that you like, and then there's going to be some things that you don't, but it's just the necessary step. And that was what Mama's Boy was. It was just us taking people back home and in a very like, and we were showing them a side of us that no one's ever seen. And that was great. And that was necessary. And I knew that I wanted to make GGBBXX while we were making Mama's Boy. I knew that this was the album that we would make right after. And I wanted it to be the antithesis or the opposite of Mama's Boy. So Mama's Boy, there's a lot of acoustic elements there, you know, like acoustic guitar, the first time anyone's ever heard acoustic guitar, there was strings and flugelhorn, and you could hear the acoustic grand piano. And I wanted to go like super opposite of that with EGBBXX. And so that was the inspiration, to go just like really super pop, really synth heavy, to kind of, if Mama's Boy was a departure, then Gigi would be the return of, or the return to LANY, and to the LANY that people kind of fell in love with in the first place, but on a bigger scale. And on a, you know, I think this album, this is the first time a LANY song is as loud as any other song that you would play next to it before or after. I think those drums are really, really big. The bass is really loud. You know, we want it to be competitive. We want to compete, and we wanted to make a big pop album, but in a way that LANY would do it, with conviction and with style. And yeah, we're not a little bedroom pop band anymore. We don't want to be. We want to grow out of that and move past that. And that's what we did with this album. I'm I'm obsessed with listening to people and their conversations and being hyper aware of what's happening around me and understanding the social dynamic and kind of psychoanalyzing people's, you know, relationships with their friends and with their loved ones and with the internet. And I'm always just looking for new ways to describe and explain very universal feelings and relatable topics, you know? So it was a very fun exercise. Like the phrase, never mind, let's break up. It's just, everyone knows exactly what I'm talking about. It's just that point of breaking and being like, dog, this is not working. Never, like, let's just break up. And songs like Getaway, which I think is a really cool way to say, like, it's a really cool love song. I've never heard anyone talk about, how did anyone let you get away? Ex I never had. This to me is crazy. I don't know if I've ever heard a song talk about when someone is out there claiming to have been way more involved with you romantically than you ever were. That is such a real life thing that, I mean, I would assume it happens to quite a lot of people. And it's just really, you know, cool to write those kind of songs that you feel like haven't been written before.
Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had?
Great question. You know, oftentimes I have song titles typed out on my phone. I have just pages of song titles, but on this particular day, I did not have an idea. And this happens, you know, when you go in and write a song every single day, some days you have ideas and some days you don't. And on the days that I don't, I like to talk and ask questions with the people I'm in the room. And I actually wrote this song with a guy named David Hodges. David Hodges is one of the best songwriters in the entire world. He was in the band Evanescence, and he was the primary songwriter of that band. So he wrote Wake Me Up Inside, which has gone like 5,000 times platinum. And an interesting story, and he'll tell you this if you were here, he got kicked out of his band the day before their album came out. And I knew this about him, and I was like, tell me the story, and have you ever written a song about it? And he's like, I actually don't think I have. And he told me this whole story, and it was a great story. And at the end, he's like, at the time it hurt because I just wish it had been up to me, you know, like it wasn't my decision. It wasn't up to me. And I was like, oh my God, bro, we have to write a song called Up to Me, but let's, you know, obviously talk about it in a relational context, which is just a very, very typical, relatable idea. Hey, I'm in love with this person. We might've been in love for a while. They decided they don't love me anymore. They broke up with me. It wasn't up to me. It wasn't my decision. I'm faced with two options. I can either roll over and die and give up on life, or I can try to move on. And sometimes when you try to move on, you still love the other person. This is like, there's been like a million movies about this. And so yeah, like I wanted to write that kind of song. And you know, it was really fun. I pulled on inspiration from years ago. That's what I think is so fun about this album is, you know, for the last 16 months, for the most part, I've been sitting on my couch, mm-hmm. watching Netflix, minding my own business. And I can't write like 12 songs about sitting on the couch. So it was really fun to kind of put myself in shoes that I'd been in maybe 3 or 4 or 5 years ago, or put myself in someone else's shoes like David Hodges and kind of imagine and paint this picture and tell the story. And I really, really enjoyed doing it. It's fun to like kind of write songs in the style of a story. And that's what we did. And I really love that song.
Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had?
Yes. You know, it was the only thing that we could really do. Most of the time we'd put out an album and then go play 130 shows around the world. And, you know, we didn't have that luxury and that privilege anymore. So, we're just trying to make the most of the hand that we've been dealt. And I think that's probably what all of you guys are doing right now. And I commend you, and I just want to say, don't give up and keep going. I know that your side of the world right now might be going through it pretty hard, and my thoughts are with you guys, and to stay strong and don't give up, and yeah, you're gonna make it out of it. And that's all that we really tried to do here is, you know, it's tough to be a band during a pandemic. You know, you can't do anything. And even if you write great songs and make great music, I think one thing that we've seen and learned is people are like, cool, it sounds great. And then a week later, they're over it. Because, music needs context. It needs moments to live in. And music needs to be coupled with experiences. And so, yeah, but hopefully we'll get out of it soon. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? You know, like every song on this album, I kept doing this when I was writing it and I was singing back. I was like, And then I even had Rachel, the girl that I work on all the creative stuff with, I even like had her take a photo of me, and then she was going to draw like a silhouette of this kind of feeling. And whatever this is what I want people to feel when they listen to Laney. Like, and maybe it's just their feeling. I don't know if it's feeling happy or feeling, but regardless, they're feeling and they mean it, and it just hits. And that's what I want.
Like, you know,
in the kitchen, you know,
like, yes,
you know, over baby, you know, just like, like, come on, yeah. Sing it to me, people. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? You know, I think like no matter what an album sounds like or no matter what topics we cover in an album, my whole goal is just to try to make people's lives like 1% better. I feel like my purpose on this planet is to write songs and to make music and to give people that music. And that's why I do it. And the message would be like, we hope you love it. We hope it makes you feel good. We hope that you feel like you're not alone, and that whatever you're going through, that I've gone through it and we've gone through it and other people have gone through it, and that you're gonna make it, and that life is a journey and it's ups and downs and peaks and valleys. But no matter what, I would love to be able to write a song for the highest of highs and the lowest of lows, and that's really all I care about. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? Coldplay, like, I would love to, I don't know how we would play with them, or like Phil Collins or something, but let's go with Phil Collins or Coldplay. I don't know how that would work. I'd probably just sit next to Chris Martin and like gawk and just be like, you're a god. You're a god amongst men. I've never met him. Doubt I ever will. But I look up to him so much. Like, I think he's one of the most magnetic and magnificent front men ever. And he makes playing the piano look so much cooler than it really is. So he's like a god to me. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? Totally. I would love to write a song with Ed Sheeran. I think he's the greatest songwriter alive. And this is a little like a new idea, but I would love to have a song with the Chainsmokers. I think a Laney Chainsmokers song would be humongous. And I've met those guys a couple times, and they are the sweetest guys ever. And I just think it'd be really, really fun. I enjoyed our collab with 220 Kid and kind of stepping, you know, taking a step into that DJ world and having a song with the Chainsmokers, just a huge, huge pop song with massive melodies and a big drop. I think that would be so damn fun. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? I guess I just have to say maybe like Last Weekend. You know, we put out the album. We got to play a small show in LA at the Troubadour, which is near and dear to our hearts. We had our first shows in LA there, and it was cool to go back. And The line was wrapped around the block several times, and that was really encouraging to see that people still cared about us and still wanted to be there. And after a year and a half, and so that was awesome. It was a real, I definitely drove past the line a couple times. I don't think anyone saw me. And then I went and cried in my car because I just thought it was awesome. And it made me feel really encouraged inside and gave me some hope. So I would say that's been the highlight of the year so far. Would you please stop acting like the ex I never had? We miss it so much, and it actually makes me sick to think that we can't come over there and play. We've now put out 2 albums. We might wind up putting 3 albums out before we get back to Asia. It's terrible. I hate it. We basically exist to play for our fans, and to not be able to do so fully is just a really shitty thing. There's no other word for it. It just really sucks. So we miss you guys and trying to do everything that we can to, you know, still hang out and see you guys and do what we can to play some music for y'all. So why are you out there acting like the ex I never had?